Hello, we're the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Today's episode will begin by looking at the upcoming launches for the remainder of the month, then we'll head over to Boca Chica with a bit of SN5 preparations, a bit of SN6 stacking and mostly SN7 testing. Let's head straight in and get up to date. As I said, we'll begin by looking at the two remaining launches expected for this month. On the SpaceX fans website, you can see that the next launch will be Starlink 9. Like with the launch of Starlink 8, this mission will contain some additional rideshare satellites. Also on the books for this month is probably the launch of the GPS-3 satellite for the Space Force. It was previously delayed in April due to the pandemic, so hopefully this month it will lift off. Before we move over to Boca Chica, I'll share with you a tweet from Elon Musk. In response to a tweet about SpaceX hiring offshore operations engineers in Brownsville, Musk responded with, "SpaceX is building floating superheavy class spaceports for Mars, Moon and hypersonic travel around Earth." Not much on SpaceX updates, so now we'll go and check out what's been happening in Boca Chica. Here you can see engineers are continuing to work over by the Starship Superheavy launch pad. We recently saw the auger in action and now they appear to be putting together some sort of rebar structure. I'm just going to throw this in here because I think it's pretty cool. A new doghouse was spotted for a doggo named Zeus. Turns out SpaceX could be getting a guard dog soon. There is also yet another new arrival in Boca Chica. You can see here some caterpillar tracks that belong to a very big crane, I believe. Will be interesting to see how large this crane actually gets, but I'm thinking it could be used for lifting starships like the Berry crane used to. There is not really many updates except SN7, so now let's take a look at SN5. Here we have the preparations of the test stand continuing and by this point it's looking near enough ready. Meanwhile, over at the construction area, SN5 is obviously still sitting outside. We've not seen the roll lift return yet, so SpaceX might wait until after they've tested the boppers. Not much on SN5, so now let's take a brief look at SN6 because not much has changed there either. As we saw from last episode, the thrust section was sitting outside the high bay hooked up to a crane. As you can see here, it has since been lifted and moved inside the high bay now that SN5 moved out. It wasn't too long before we got to see this final SN6 section stacked. Although we didn't get to see the actual stacking process, you can see here they lifted the existing tank section. After which they moved it to the old SN5 spot where the thrust section was waiting to join it. One thing I'd like you to have a look at is the quality difference between these two. SN5 in comparison with the build of SN6 looks a lot more messy and battered. Looks like they might have made some significant progress welding wise between SN5 and SN6. Finally, now let's take a look at the bulk of the action with the SN7 bopper as we saw last episode. Throughout the weekend, SpaceX worked fast to prepare this tank for testing. It was moved to the test area, hooked up, and I believe on Sunday they even did an ambient temperature pressure test. On Monday, they began the process of testing this Pathfinder tank. Whilst it was unknown what the end result of the test would be, a bunch of assumptions were made that it was a test to failure. Eric Berger shared the NSF stream to Musk saying the big question is whether they push it to failure. Musk responded to say, "That's the goal, there are a few known weak points on the test tank, probably capable of more pressure. The second test tank to follow shortly has addressed the weak points." SpaceX spent many hours on Monday filling the tank with liquid nitrogen. The tank got very frosty and even though it was extremely hot in Texas, the whole tank was pretty much covered in ice. They continued to fill it and meanwhile it continued to vent. At some point there was a huge amount of venting that we thought might have been the pop. However, after the cloud cleared, it was evident that SN7 was still good, but also venting had stopped. They seemingly closed off the valves and continued to raise the pressure to see how high it would get. We were somewhat expecting a pretty big pop, a nice bang and a little bit of mess. However, that didn't happen, and instead a white plume started spewing out the top. As was expected, it wasn't long before Elon Musk took to Twitter to give us the results. Eric Berger captioned the NSF livestream and tweeted, "Not dead yet." Musk responded to say, "Tank didn't burst but leaked at 7.6 bar. This is a good result and supports the idea of 304L stainless being better than 301. We are developing our own alloy to take this even further. Leak before burst is highly desirable." One of the final things I'll show you is a fantastic close-up view of the test tank leak. Cooper Heim captured this great footage of a little hole in the bulkhead leaking. As Elon mentioned in a previous tweet, this test tank had some known weak points. I may be wrong, but this leak looks like it could be at a weld point on the bulkhead. so maybe the leak was related to one of the weak points. However, as Musk mentioned, this should be resolved on the next test vehicle. Also spotted over in a tent at a construction yard was this little nose. I don't believe we've seen this nose yet, but I could be wrong and this could be a nose that we've already seen. However, it's currently anybody's guess as to what SN version any of these nose cones will be used for. As always, a massive thank you goes to Mary Boca Chica Girl and the whole NSF team who spend hours providing us with live testing views. We are all incredibly grateful to you guys, so keep doing what you're doing. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.